Down to the last corner on the molecule, but the backup is here. But today we have to talk about a classic. Tom Ford, Grave Vetiver, and why you better get this now. Welcome to the channel where fashion meets spring. My name is Kevin Samuels, your style godfather. Today I'm wearing my Tom Ford gray suit to talk about the masterpiece Tom Ford Grave Vetiver and why you better get it now. If you like these kind of videos, great, go ahead and subscribe and drop a like down below. Shout out to the CIA. Gentlemen, if you've been watching my channel for any length of time, you know I love Tom Ford's fashion. I refer to Tom Ford as the master for many different things. I love his take on style. And when he released his private line fragrance collection in 2007, it got even better. Fragrance I want to talk about today is one of his best, Tom Ford Grave Vetiver. This is the Eau de Parfum. I often say this is the best clean masculine fragrance any man can wear. I talk about the Marlboro Man steps off the billboard. Shout out to the CIA. One love, FBI. If you want to become part of the movement, make sure you join me on Patreon for exclusive video and live stream content. Join me on that platform for things you will only see there. Details down in the description. In my opinion, guys, this is a must-have for any classic man. It's made it on several of my lists, spring, summer, winter, fall. It's potent enough to where it is signature scent worthy and can be worn anywhere, any season, for any reason. But why are we talking about it today? Well, unfortunately, guys, this fragrance, as I understand it, is being discontinued or removed from the regular line. For quite a while now, I've been hearing inklings and rumors about this. However, here in Atlanta, I've had it confirmed directly from my Tom Ford regional manager that this is being removed from the line. Is it going to come back in another iteration? I don't know, and I'm going to tell you right now, the way I feel about this fragrance, I would not take that chance. I suggest if you dig this fragrance, you go out and get it now, because you know how these things happen. Once they're gone, the price is going to go. And I have often said that this fragrance right here, in my opinion, if this were a private blend, they could charge easily $300 or $400 for it and people wouldn't blink. Now, the difference between the EDT and the EDP, in my opinion, the EDT is brighter, crisper, projects more because of the higher alcohol content, and is more appropriate for guys 30 and under. For guys 30 and over, I much prefer the EDP, because it just has this way of developing on your skin and it plays a little bit closer. Either way, the EDT or the EDP, both of these are signature scent worthy masterpieces in my opinion. And I don't use that masterpiece word lightly. This is a masterpiece of a fragrance, and the fact that you can get it for right around $100 US on some discounters is incredible. Guys, do yourself a favor. Even if you still have some left in your existing bottle, don't let this chance pass up to where when you look up and this is gone and you go back out on the market, maybe later on this year, next year, and you say, oh no, I need to re-up on my Tom Ford Grave Vetiver, and it's gone. Now, I know some people will be like, he's just being an alarmist. There will always be these fragrances around, and I want you to look at these two. The Tom Ford Extreme, which just 3 years ago was readily available at even Sephora, or Macy's, wherever. You can't get your hands on it now. And Tom Ford Sahara Noir came out right around the time of White Patchouli. And if you try to get your hands on this one right now, this one's gonna cost you upwards of $250, and this one over here is gonna cost you about $150, if you can find it. I would anticipate the same thing with Grave Vetiver, probably even more because of the wearability. I can easily see their price doubling or tripling. Kind of like YSL Eau Nuit, how when they did the reformulation, that fragrance is still on the market, and look at the prices for pre-2012 bottles. In my opinion, this one right here is going to have even more of an increase as the market starts to dry up. If you want to take a chance, do that. But for me, it's too good of a fragrance not to have in my collection. I have my bottle and my backup bottles just because I need my supply. Do me a favor, guys. Hit me up in the comment section. Let me know, what is your favorite Tom Ford fragrance? What do you like to rock? What do you like to wear? What is your go-to from the master? Hey guys, whether look, style, or life, whether personal or professional, you can level up and be your personal best each and every day. If you're interested in any of that, do us both a favor, follow the link in the description and book your one-on-one session with me. Details down in the description. Peace.